one of those moments in time where, you know, the world stops for a second.
So White Sox Ace is a travel baseball program based out of Chicago that gives opportunities to black and brown young people in the city to play some high caliber travel baseball along with academic opponents as far as ACT prep, SAT prep, fully just getting them ready for life after baseball. We've been around for about 17 years now. It's one of the top programs in the Midwest, and we like to pride ourselves on, you know, helping create change agents in the city.
To me, when getting that call, I mean, it's pretty much a dream come true because I really grew up around that program. And Trey just came out that program, so I just wanted to like basically contain the legacy, I guess, and making my own sort of impact to it. Just them being really supportive to me just really means a lot.
A girl playing baseball for the best travel baseball program in the country, by far. No other major league team is doing that.
So when I first saw that Amira made the team, I was extremely proud of her. It was a sign of relief, but it was a sign that, you know, we had to put more work in because now she's playing with the big boys now, and she's got to get bigger. She's got to get stronger and faster.
It is a lot of added pressure going into that because you have to be good mentally to have that sort of push and keep on going and just keep on working.
History. I mean, she's the first to do it. She's breaking barriers and kicking down doors for other young ladies to come behind her. When it first happened, her making the program, everybody was so excited and just like, this is something new, and we just want to see how it play out, and she's held her own. It shows that girls can play this game too.
Atta girl, way to get it through, kid. Let's go, Amira!
Oh my goodness, my earliest memory of Amira in baseball is her going to one of Trey's t-ball games. It was right after she was born. I think she was about 5 days old. We'd been discharged from the hospital for about 2 days, and he had a game that Saturday, and we were sitting outside, and the game was about to start, and I just decided to walk on over to the park, and there she was at 5 days old.
Probably when Amira was around 7 and 8 years old that she really kind of like got into it. Like, I feel like, you know, why not have a young lady as Amira be able to play baseball at that age? It's really, you know, not a big deal. Like, you know, all the girls, boys, whoever, you know, you're still learning the game, you know. But after that, it turned into that, you know, she was starting to, you know, just fit in just like any other kid.
I think Amira being around baseball totally impacted her learning the game so quickly. It seems like she just knew from early on.
Oh, well, I started playing with Trey when I was 12. Just like everywhere we went, she went, you know, especially if it was baseball related, she was always there and she was just around and taking in the knowledge, and people don't really know how effective that it can be when you get older.
You know, Amira would always, you know, be in the dugout, hanging around, and, you know, at some point you kind of see that she was, you know, soaking in the game, just kind of being astute, you know, just looking, and she's swinging her legs, a little bitty thing. And I think at that point, that was the starting point of her saying, you know what, you know, why not, you know, see how far she would want to, you know, kind of take this, you know, just see what happened.
Her dad coaches an all-girls baseball team, and they might have practice at the same time that Amira has Ace practice. And so I'll drop her off at Ace practice, and as soon as she gets out of that practice, she's wanting me to run her over to where her dad is coaching the all-girls team so she can get more reps. And we're just from practice to practice, sometimes 2 and 3 times in the same day.
Her work ethic is basically just at home, training, hitting the tire, going to our trainer, Coach Griff, and working out there pretty much every day of the week.
Her work ethic, man, Amira's work ethic is kind of off the charts for her age.
Right, you got some kids that get out there and just say, all right, I'm gonna go through the motion. You got some kids that get out there and say, I'm not really feeling it. Like, every day she comes, she's out there to kick.
Amira come to take care of business.
She's out there to, you know, really lock in on what's, she wants to win, she wants to compete.
You know, it's times where guys, you know, and athletes, like, coach, I get a water break. Amira like, coach, what's my next set? What's my next rep? She don't want to stop. I hate to say it, it's kind of crazy because even when the workout done, she's still looking to get more. She just got this niche about herself that she just want to work. And be honest with you, I mean, out of all my athletes, I work at this probably in the top 10.
How many athletes do you have?
I got 894 athletes.
I did not believe in girls playing baseball. Reasons to be that at the time you didn't see it. It was something that was uncommon.
I just really can't fit in. I have to do 10 times better or work 10 times harder than the boys or do everything 10 times better to outshine everybody.
I'm pretty sure she takes a lot of criticism.
There have been times where I feel like I've overheard parents in the stands or parents from other teams saying things that weren't 100% positive.
You know, some other her teammates looking at her like, well, who is she to think that she should be playing baseball?
It seemed like they weren't necessarily cheering her on.
Can she handle it? Can she stick? Is she going to be, you know?
You know, she's not going to be able to do it. She's a female playing.
Amira got MVP in a tournament more than once, and parents were questioning why she was getting MVP so many times, or...
You know, like, what are we really doing here?
What happened when the game speeds up? What happened when the games get stronger?
Why she was playing the position that she was playing.
Is she gonna have, you know, that some of that, as I call it, manpower that you expect, you know, baseball guys to have? You probably see on the softball, but she's still able to do some of the things that some of my baseball guys can't do. At one moment, I was like, she maybe can't do this, but the next moment, she's doing it. She had in her mind to say, you know, even though I am a female, I want to play baseball, and she stuck with it. And I think what we could take from this story is that, you know, never let no one say you can't do it. I mean, we've been here all our lives, right? Now Amira's living it.
It just brings joy to me knowing that what I'm doing is inspiring them to follow my footsteps and be able to keep growing the game and keep changing the game. What I'm doing just helps everybody. It's just changing everything throughout the game.
You know, it's just been such a satisfying thing to know that that girls can do it. You know, there is no limitation on what someone can do.
A lot of girls, they get to a certain age and they're like, I'm gonna make the transition to softball. The game gets faster, the fields get bigger, the kids get stronger. Amira's like, I'm here, like this is what I'm doing. She doesn't quit. I've seen her have some rough days at the field. She comes back the next day with a smile, like, whatever, let's do it again.
My message for girls that would want to play baseball is don't listen to any haters or anybody that tells you you can't, because they just try to just bring you down and just tell you that you can't because everybody is brainwashed and think it's a men's sport because it's baseball is for boys and they have softball for girls. But there's no really a written rule that girls can't play baseball because, I mean, clearly, it's a whole women's national team. Monet has did it. I have done it. If whatever anybody else has to say, just don't listen to them because it's girls out here doing what you want to do. So don't listen to them.
Hondras. Amira recently made the Chicago White Sox ACE program. So the White Sox ACE program is a program Chicago White Sox funded through the White Sox Charities Department, and they actually provide inner city youth with free opportunities to play baseball and earn collegiate scholarships. So they're doing wonderful things. Shout out to the ACE program. And I have the first ever, yeah, you heard it right here on the recess first, the first ever young lady to make the program, Miss Amira Hondras. So make sure y'all give her a virtual clap right now. We got the whole backyard, the whole South Holland is in the building, and Chicago people joining in. So I'm gonna start this thing off. Amira, how old were you when you first started playing baseball?